Welcome back. We've discussed schemes used for managing IP addresses, which naturally leads us to the concept of IP subnets. We want to break off certain machines and put them into groups that we can talk to at once. In order to facilitate that, we add what's called a subnet mask, which is a way to mask off a number of machines that will receive a certain broadcast. When expressing subnets, we have the same concept as an IP address, 4 octets. To give the simplest explanation, a 255 in an octet means that the corresponding octet of the device IP will have to match to make that group. A 0 in an octet means a device can have any IP address in that place and be a member of the group, as long as it meets the other conditions. Values other than 255 and 0 are allowed in subnets, but we'll discuss those later. So let's look at a common case. Here is a subnet that includes the IP address 192.168.1.101 with a subnet mask of 255.255.255.0. We know that all machines on this subnet must have 192.168.1 in the address due to the 255s in those corresponding places in the subnet mask. We have a 0 in the last place, which would suggest that 0 through 255 would all be allowable values for an IP address to have in its last place and still be included in this subnet. However, there are two special cases. The first address in the subnet range, 0 in this example, is reserved to define the subnet, and the last address is reserved as the broadcast address for that subnet. So that leaves us with the following. A subnet address of 192.168.1.0, which defines the subnet, a host range of 192.168.1.1 through 254, which are IP addresses that machines on the subnet can have, and a broadcast address of 192.168.1.255. That's the address we can use to talk to all of these machines at once. When subnets were originally specified, they were what we refer to now as classful subnets. Each range was specifically defined. A lot of the IP schemes we see now are holdovers from those original definitions. Class A networks are defined as having first octets 1 through 126 with a subnet mask of 255.0.0.0. The most commonly used subnet in the range is 10.0.0.0. Note that these subnets have up to almost 16.8 million possible hosts. That's never done these days, so if you've seen it, it's mostly in the form of a more restrictive subnet. Class B networks use the subnet mask 255.255.0.0 with the first octets of 128 through 191. This allows for a little over 65,000 hosts per subnet, which is still a large number of devices. The most common address schemes coming from this class are ones beginning in 172. Class C networks are the most common ones we see, from your own home networks to those in our workplaces, etc. These are small subnets with up to 254 devices. Almost everyone has seen a 192.168.0.x or 192.168.1.x IP address if they're looking. And now that routers are so much less expensive and prevalent, subnets tend to be in this range or smaller. There's no need for a giant Class A or Class B subnet anymore. Note that the IP ranges in the Class A, B, and C network definitions are never found on the internet. These ranges are specifically set aside for internal networks. Addresses of machines on the internet themselves are very carefully set aside and assigned to avoid catastrophe. We mentioned before that subnets could be defined outside of the rules and classifications we just discussed. Doing this is referred to as classless interdomain routing, or CIDR, CIDR. To explain, we'll need to convert an IP address to binary, which is even more fun than hexadecimal. Let's say we wanted to start with IP address 192.168.1.1 and create a subnet smaller than Class C. the binary representation of that address is to the right. Note, a Class C subnet would be represented as 24 ones from the right, with 8 ones representing 255 as a decimal. To make our subnet one size smaller, we add a 25th one to the subnet mask going from the right. Every one in the subnet mask represents the bits in the address that define the network, so they're called the network bits. The host range of the subnet is determined by the zeros in the subnet mask, represented here in dark blue. If we convert all of this back to decimal, we have a subnet mask of 255.255.255.128. In what we call CIDR notation, we specify the subnet address, which is 192.168.1.0, with a slash and then the number of network bits, which is 25 in this case. This makes the allowable host range 192.168.1.1 to 192.168.1.126. The final address, 192.168.1.127, that becomes the broadcast address for the subnets. So, does your head hurt yet? Because mine does. You know, all of this seems complicated, but, you know, there are online calculators to make this easy. And here are a couple of examples. If you're given an IP and a net mask by your corporate IT, you can easily find the host range. If you need to define a custom subnet, you know, you can do that as well. So let's take a break here, and in the next section, we'll dive into how to actually troubleshoot some of these issues when you're on a project site.